Noah Callahan could always count on his whole family to be there for his hockey games. That is until his dad needed a COVID-19 vaccine to get into the arena.
It hurts you that I don't go, right?
Yes.
Like it in your heart?
Yeah.
You don't think it hurts my heart that I can't go?
No, because you're making that choice.
Paul is the outlier in his family, the only one who's against getting vaccinated. A decision, he says, is rooted in his faith in God.
His blood is shed all over me, so it's like my shield.
But these are the times of these kids' lives that you'll never, ever get back again, and you're missing it all. Mm-hmm. You're missing it all because you've chosen not to get a vaccination.
The first principle to maintaining relationships, even if you have a difference in viewpoint, is to be non-judgmental.
This family doctor says the first step for families seeking to find common ground is setting aside uninterrupted time to talk.
Everyone gets 5 minutes to say what they're thinking, and then the conversation ends, and come back to the table maybe 3 or 4 days later or a week later.
She says giving people that space can create more time to reflect on their decisions.
It's just crazy that some people won't want to get it. I've told them that it's easier to get it because we'll be able to do everything again, like what we did in normal life.
Noah is 11 years old and wants to be vaccinated, but his doctor told him to wait. He was born with a heart defect, and the vaccine could make him vulnerable to side effects. His mom and sister are fully dosed to protect themselves and him.
If you can't do it for yourself, do it for your family. Do it for Noah. We, as the adults, are his protector. And it's up to us to protect him.
The Callahans have had conversations on this for months, but nothing's changed.
You just gotta respect other people's choices.
If they want to come out of this pandemic as a family, acceptance may be their way forward. Jasmine Pisano, Global News, Trenton, Ontario.